Welcome. Today we're going to talk about facility and product layout planning, and also a little bit on optimization. The first actual piece that we need to do before we can really go into too much detail is really kind of talk about what is a layout and what do we mean by layout planning. So there's two real types of definitions that we want to make sure that you understand. One is facility layout. Facility layout is how do we decide what's best? How do we physically arrange items around either on a plant floor or a whole building? Where are we going to put all of our resources? Where are we going to put what types of things consume different types of space? Now, these are usually things like machines. These could be where we have different departments, such as in a hospital. We have different equipment that perform different things. This is the kind of thing that we're trying to plan on where do we put what. Now with that, it also matters what type of system we're trying to design. So a system where we're trying to design something like in a hospital is very different than when we're trying to design, say, a manufacturing process. So those are different types of systems. The other thing we have to look at is it a intermittent processing system where we have very low volume, but we have maybe many different products, or we're looking at something that's very repetitive. We have a very high volume and a few standardized products. So those are very different system types to design for. So in general, we have four layouts that we like to talk about. There's the type ones, that's process layout. This is where we can group similar resources, put them together that do similar functions, do the similar things. Then there's a type two, the product layouts. This is where we have designed to produce a specific product very efficiently. So that's a completely different type of thing. Then there's mixed systems, mixed ones and twos. We call these hybrids, as would be expected. We combine aspects of both process and product layouts. So sometimes you need a little bit of the best of both worlds. And then there's the full type two, where there's a fixed position layout. And this is kind of a subset where a product is too large really to move. So let's talk about each one of these four in a little more detail. So again, the process layout type one has some unique characteristics to it. The resources are used for general purpose. The facilities are less capital intensive, more labor intensive. Resources have greater flexibility. The processing rates are slower. Material handling costs are typically higher in these situations. Scheduling resources, workflow is a little bit more complex, and the space requirements are higher. What's a good example of that? A hospital, university, metalworking shop, department stores, tool and die manufacturers, Walmart. That's another good example of a process layout. So in the type two category for a product layout, it has some different characteristics. So here we have very specialized resources. They are capital intensive facilities. They are processing rates much faster. Material handling costs are much lower. Space requirements for inventory, we try to keep those very low. And flexibility is low relative to the market. Some examples of these are an assembly line, say like a See's candy assembly line, cafeterias, a car wash where we have things going on the line, or Toyota, a car manufacturing line. That makes sense. What would be a hybrid? Something where it's a little bit between this. These are coming in a little bit backwards. It's where we combine the elements of both product and process, where we can maintain some of the efficiencies of product layouts, but we need a little bit of flexibility in there. That's where the process layout comes in. So these can be usually in mini type twos, where we can have what we call group technology. GTs are cell layouts. We'll talk about that in another lecture. Identification parts of the process, they can be standardized and produce maybe an intermediary product before we get to the final product. So things like this, or maybe some larger items like Winnebago, where we have campers, retail stores, grocery stores. So these are some examples of that. All right. So the last type that we wanted to talk about was the fixed position layout. Again, this is a type two. In this case, we have a product that is either very difficult or near impossible to move. In other words, once we build it, we want it to stay there. Or once we don't want to move it until the entire thing's built. So these are things like structures, anything in construction, bridges, dams, large ships, large aircraft. These are common things that you want to build all in one place. So because of that, you have to bring all the resources be brought to the site or to where you're developing the product. And then you're basically scheduling crews and the resources that have to come in and out of that system. So it's a very different type of layout, and it's kind of a special case. Okay, that's it for the intro. The next thing we're going to talk about later in the next presentation is process layout specifically. Thank you.